You know, I've been thinking, well, let me put it this way. In the States, there's a, you know, you have what they call a Republican Party, and there's this faction of the Republican Party that's completely enamored with Ayn Rand. Ayn Rand is a writer, and she was a Soviet. Okay, she was Russian, then it became the Soviet Union, and she fled and came here, and she's just some sort of so-called cold capitalism and all that stuff. And they worship her and all that stuff. And I'm going like, but I know Ayn Rand. In fact, I want to know Ayn Rand Taylor in the 70s. I mean, I read all of her books, including what really led me to it, because I was doing, it's been in the late 70s, because she had a play. She did this play, very unique play, where basically the convention, where it was a trial, but she picked a jury from the audience. So every night there'd be a different jury from the audience. So the audience, you know, the jury sat on stage and they got a good view of the play. It was very unique, it was very good, and I liked it. And I read all her books, you know, the majors, one being The Fountainhead and Atlas Shrugged, and, you know, Athens, a bunch of things, We Are One, something like that. But when I read her play, I read it as a play, because it was a playwright, and I liked it. But when I read her books, her novels, I read it as like what's called a gothic novel. It's long, sprawling novel with this romance, you know, woman and independent man. And but this so-called faction of the Republican or right wing, whatever they're labeling these people these days, are all up about is that she was about the individual and you know, it's the individual that does everything. And in the book, they had this guy, he makes this huge housing project, and then he doesn't like the way they're treating it, so he blows up the housing project because it was his creation and they didn't do any of most of the stuff. It was kind of interesting because I didn't look at it like that. You know, I didn't look at it like, hey, it's just a good, it was a good novel to me. I didn't look at no political thing or anything like that, but it was nice, a lot of stuff in there. I go on and on and on about this because the central part was that when this guy built this housing project, he built it certain scale to the grass to the land area. In other words, how tall were you would build a building according to how much grass area you had down there. You couldn't build a building so tall that there was no place for people to play or walk or whatever have you. So I bring all that up because I think it was basically based on, maybe it wasn't because maybe it was. I lived on 14th Street in New York. There was a housing project called Stuyvesant Town, Stuytown. You know, it was a housing project, but it was sort of a private public one. It was first built. They discriminated, you know, black people and stuff that kind of thing. Because it was in the 40s they built it, and it was a beautiful place, you know. And, you know, and I could see where they had the proportions just right for the height of the building versus the grass and the trees and all the rest of that stuff. And there's a lot of projects in New York, but they're not built the same way. There's a lot of building, but no space, you know, to roll the kiddies around with and whatever they're having. So I look at all this stuff and I realize things are not just the planning, it's not just the execution, but it's the follow through and the maintenance. So if you can't follow through, then you're going to have problems. So when they change these things, they make these huge, big housing projects with no place for people to play, whatever have you, then, you know, the streets get cluttered and stuff happens. And there's no follow through to say, hey, we made a mistake here, what should we do? And I think that's the problem with a lot of things these days. We have a good plan. We might have a all right execution. Sometimes they use faulty, you know, building materials. But then there's really no follow-through or maintenance or something way to sustain it. That's the big, 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 big problem. Even if you have a vision and you can execute it, if you can't maintain it, if there's no follow-through, it's going to crash just like that. So there you are. This is one of those dispatches from ArtsDirector Emeritus. So that would be me, T. from the Patterson, taking the train to the bed, letting you know what I only suspect.